Now I will solve some R programming examples by using POSIT Cloud. Let me adjust music level. Yeah, it's good. I will use POSIT Cloud to perform the R interpreter. I will open a new R Studio project and let's start. Question 6 says there will be a data set, it is called a real electricity market US day ahead price.csv. We will download it to R. After that we will solve the following questions. Let's start. I will open new R script. To solve this question we need to use some libraries like library tidyr, ggplot2, mqts, what was that, there will be dplayer, and last one is coreplot. Of course we have to install them first, so I will use install packages code to install tidyr. Let's make control C and control V. There will be file library and I will just change the names of them. And the last one is coreplot for correlation map. Let's install them first, then we will start to write code. Yeah, all libraries are installed, so we can start to solution. What was the dataset name? Are you like this market? We will upload it to the POSIT Cloud from here. Are you like this to the market dataset? I uploaded here, let's call it. I'm gonna call it as data and read.csv parentheses. I will take the name of it. It is here. Control C, Control V, and I will add .csv. And there will be like this. Let's check. Yeah, we load the data here. You can see there will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8 column here. And let's check the questions. I will decrease the sound. Little bit. Okay. Calculate the mean values of each column in the original dataset. We will calculate the mean values, but before calculate the mean values, first we have to notice something. Time step is not numeric. There is a lot of time variable here. We have to ignore it. How are we gonna do that? We can perform it like this. I'm saying numeric data will be from data. I will use select function to eliminate it. I will say select where is that numeric. In that way I will just obtain the numeric data, which means time step column will be ignored. Num data, let's check this one. Yeah, you can see that time step eliminated and other those columns remain here. Now we can calculate the mean value. I'm saying mean. I will use numData, but we have to use call means function. call means num data NaRM equals true and print means. Let's check. You can see we obtained the mean values of each column. What about the next question? Find the number of cells that are smaller than 500 joule over megawatt hour. Elaborate the numbers for each column separately. How are we gonna perform that? We have numeric data here. We will look for smaller than 500, right? So I'm saying less than 500 maybe goes to data. After that, we have to use call sums here. Call. After that, I'm saying data, comma, data smaller than 500, we can say. Actually, we have to use numeric value here. Num data smaller than 500, NaRM equals true, and print less 500. Let's check. Now we obtained the less than 500 values here. And the next question says, use linear interpolation to impute the cells that are smaller than 500. We are using imputeTS library to perform this calculation. I'm saying imp data will be goes there, and we will take the data from data, of course, and then we have to use NA interpolation. We will take data from data, and I will say option will be linear. If you do not know how to use NA interpolation, for example, you can use help function and write NA interpolation here. Click enter. Yeah, NA interpolation x option linear. I'm using this syntax here, and we perform the imputation, but let's say it will be smaller than 500. I'm saying imp data and imp data smaller than 500, that will goes to NA, and print imp data. Let's check. Yeah, we may perform the imputation calculation here. It's okay, I think. After that, it says calculate the mean values of each column in the imputed data set. I'm saying imputation imp mean equals call means parentheses. I will use imp data comma and NaRM will be true. Print imp mean. Right? I think so. Let's paste it. X must be numeric, it said. It's giving this error because we use data, and data include time values. So I have to say num data here, and now it will work. Yeah, you can see. Now we found the imputed mean values. What about last question? Plot correlation maps and determine strongest correlation for both the original and the imputed data set. Okay, I will say correlation for original. I will use core function, and for original I will use num data comma. I will use say use equals complete dot ods. After that, I will use core plot function and core original comma method circle. This will create the core plot for original dataset, and I will perform it for imputation. I will say core imputed core function, and I will use imp data. Right. After that, I will say use complete.obs in core plot. I will use core imputed comma method goes circle, and this will also create a correlation map for the imputation imputed data. Now question says determine the strongest correlation for both the original and the imputed data set. Alright, how are we gonna do that? We will use I am trying to memorize that. I couldn't memorize it right now. I'm saying max core original equals to max. I will say core original, and then I will open this parenthesis. After that I will say log 3 and then core original again. And if I say print max core original, I will obtain the result. Core org not found. Where did I put comma? Here. That will be like this. Yeah. What about another thing? Max core imputed. I will use max core imputed lower the 3 parentheses core imputed. After that print max core imputed. Yeah, this is the end of the question. We perform all solutions. Thank you so much for listening to me.